Another one of the Connecticut clockmaking giants was the E. Ingraham Company, Elias Ingraham. He actually also worked in the earlier days of clockmaking, but went in and out of business, had various of his factories burned down, as most of them did sometime during their history, but really got going strong later in the 1800s. He got very active in making the mass-produced clocks that you're going to find if you're looking for antique clocks. This is an example, kind of a sorry one, but it's one that I could dig up out of my shop quickly. It's an example of a black mantle clock. The way that you can spot Ingraham clocks almost immediately is because they have a slow fast adjuster poking out of the dowel right there above the center shaft. So this was an innovation, or let's say at least an adaptation of a way to make a slow fast adjustment on these ticking clocks in a way that was different than the others. It's a little wheel that you push one way or the other. But millions of E. Ingraham clocks were made. Again, I point you to a Tranduy Dooley book, which relates to Ingraham, where you can read all about the history of the man and his products. He was also, at least claims to have been, the inventor of the steeple clock that we looked earlier. He called it the sharp Gothic at the time, but at least some credit him with that design, which was an important early step in mass-produced clockmaking. This is of a later style, obviously, black mantle. We'll look at these again when we're talking about styles, but just you can always peek in the back and you can see the movement inside and make sure that it is still in there and that it's a clock that's going to tick and strike for you happily.